My video lecture in Chameleon Values and Norms. No, today is August 26, 2022. It's a Friday morning, and we will have a weekend ahead of us. So for today, I'd like to remind you people that the book that we are using is this one, no? Chameleon Values and Norms. This book is available in the LRI, no? Learning Resources Institute. Now, also, I'd like to inform you again or remind you that the video lectures, which although I have already stated this in our GC, no, group chat, the video lectures in CVN will come out every Wednesday and Friday morning, just like today, no? So there is no time, but it will always be in the morning. Anyway, the video lectures are quite short, so please bear with the viewing of or seeing the video lectures consistently, because these are very important foundations prior to taking the CVB. So as promised yesterday, we will have the first video lecture today, and our topic will be on what we call values, no? Values. I think most of you have already an idea of values. And then, of course, related to values are what we call norms, no? Then, of course, if you violate any of this, if you violate, no? Of course, there is what we call sanctions, no? Sanctions. So, briefly, I would like to discuss each one. Now, when we talk of values, we are talking about the general guidelines, no? General guidelines or standards, no? We call that standards, no? General guidelines or standards that define, what else? Define, motivate, and guide our actions or behavior, no? So I repeat, when we talk of values, we are talking about the general guidelines, standards, no, or ideals, no, that guide, motivate, and define our actions and behavior. Now, when we talk of norms, on the other hand, by the way, these are two different things, no? When we talk of values, we talk about this. When we talk of norms, we are talking about specific what? Patterns of behavior. Specific patterns of behavior that what? No? These are specific patterns of behavior that are usually what? That are usually that are usual, customary, and normal. That are usual, customary, or desirable, no? Desirable, no? So here, when we talk of values, we talk about the general one, and these are usually the means to achieve our goals in life, no? When we talk about norms, they are specific patterns of behavior that are usual, customary, or desirable. Now, from this word alone, from the word norms, of course, these are normal, no? The things that we do on a normal, basis, no? Now, if you violate any of these two, no, values or norms, of course, you may be imposed what we call sanctions. So, sanctions are actually penalties or punishments, no? Penalties or punishments. Of course, they take in different forms, no? The penalty that may be imposed for values may be different from the imposition of sanctions in the case of norms, no? Okay, so before, these are just a brief discussion of these three concepts. But for now, we will be concentrating our discussion on what we call values. So anyone who could give me an example of values, of course, we just take the ones that are stated in the book, no? So perhaps the best example would be, of course, what we call honesty, no? Of course, let us take honesty, for instance, as an example. Do you agree with me that this is a value? Of course it is. Now, when you value honesty, no, when you value honesty, of course, you do not want people to cheat, no? You hate cheating, no? You hate cheating, telling stories that are not true, yung mga marites, no? Telling stories that are not true, no? Or even during examinations, you copying during exams, no? So these are examples or manifestations that you are really valuing honesty, no? You do not want cheating, no? You do not want telling stories that are not true. You do not want copying during examinations, etc. So these are just examples, no? And we take it to mean that honesty is one of the values that you hold very dear in your life, because this is very, very important. So let's take another example, no? Before we proceed to the general characteristics of values. Of course, when we talk about the value of courage, you understand courage, no? Matapang or fierce, no? Fierceness, no? So when you value courage, of course, what are the things that you want? Well, you speak up, no? You speak up to tell your principles or your beliefs, no? You speak up for your beliefs. Of course, you also want to navigate, no? Navigate. This is a common word. Navigate. Uncharted territories, diba? Or you are very adventurous to something that is new, diba? These are traits of being courageous, no? You speak up, you are not silent, but you want to say whatever principle or belief you believe in. You navigate uncharted, no? These are territories or choices that are not proven yet, for instance, no? And of course, you are very adventurous to going places, wherever that place may be. So you agree with me that this is also a value, okay? Next would be, say for instance, of course, another value that I may cite or I may mention would be the value of what we call loyalty, no? Because Filipinos are very loyal to one another, no? The value of loyalty, you agree with me that this is also a value that you hold very dear? The answer is yes. No, so when you are loyal, of course, what do? When you are loyal, well, you are loyal for your country, for instance, for your country. So you help your country grow, no? You help your country grow. And you are proud to be a Filipino. Proud to be a Filipino. No? Wherever you are, you speak good about your country, about your sense of nationalism and identity, because you are loyal. Now, if you are also loyal to a friend, for instance, loyalty to a friend, of course, you do not speak ill, no? You do not speak, not speaking ill. Ka nag-ano, no, sinisiraan about your friend, no? Do not speak ill about your friend, nothing that is derogatory at all. Or if you are loyal to your school, of course, for CCM, if you are loyal to your school, someday, somehow, when you have your job, of course, as an alumnus or alumna of this institution, you may also want to share your blessings, no? Share your blessings because you are loyal, very loyal to your Alma Mater. Okay? So these are the three values that I mentioned. What are the common or general characteristics of these values that I am mentioning? No? Of course, there are general characteristics of values. Can you mention one? Anyone from the class? Okay. Let us proceed with the general characteristics of values. No? General characteristics of values. So we will now know if the different attributes or characteristics of values. Okay, the first one is, I told you already, they are general guidelines, no? General guidelines or principles. Principles or ideals, no? That what? That define, guide, or motivate our actions. What else? Our choices, our attitudes, no, attitudes, our preferences, and our decisions, no? Our decisions. So I repeat, one characteristic of values is this. They are general guidelines or principles or ideals, not ideas, but ideals, that define, guide, or motivate our actions, our choices, our attitudes, our preferences, and our decisions. Meaning to say, because they are our general guidelines, when we decide or make our choices, no, the value component will always be there. No, the value component, we just do not decide based on our whims or caprices, no? We do not decide based on our whims or caprices, but of course, when we decide, there is always the invocation, or we always have to think about the values that we hold very important in life. Okay? Clear? So when we decide, we are guided by the values that we hold very dear, because these are the general guidelines, principles that define, that guide, that motivate our actions, our preferences, our behavior, our conduct, our attitudes, no, our choices, our decisions, etc., etc. Okay, clear so far? What else? What is another characteristic of values? Okay, we proceed. So remember that, no, values are general guidelines, ideals, or beliefs. The second one is, of course, values have an order, no? An order in the hierarchy. Do you understand the word hierarchy? Hierarchy of values. So meaning, when there is an order in the hierarchy of values, what is a hierarchy? Well, of course, that is like a rank, no? Or order, no? Parang it's like a staircase, no? Stairs, no? So, of course, when we talk that there is an order in the hierarchy of values, we are talking about which value is most important to you. Perhaps you have your first, no? You have categorized the second most important and the third the least important. So, there is the order there, no? The most important, the important ones, and the least important. There is an order, no? An order is like a stair, no? Something like, okay, nandito yung bottom, then the second one, the third one, the fourth one, no? There is an order, 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, the lowest would be what? The least important for you. Next, least important would be this. Then, the most important will, of course, be the higher one, no? And relative to this, or what shall I say, if you want a further reading on this order or of hierarchy of values, I'd like to refer you to a German philosopher by the name of Max Ferdinand Weber. No? His name is Max Ferdinand, which Max Ferdinand Schiller, rather. No, he's a German philosopher who lived, he was born in 1874 and died in 1928. No? What did this philosopher do? Well, he conceived the theory of value. So I'd like you to research on this. No? The theory of value of Max Ferdinand Schiller. No? In his theory of value. Can I erase this now? No? There is an order in the hierarchy of values. So Max Ferdinand Schiller was the one who conceived what we call the, come again, the theory of value. The theory of value. Who conceived this again? His name is Max Ferdinand Schiller. No? So first, let us discuss this briefly. His theory of value. No? Let us discuss the theory of value of Max Ferdinand Schiller. No? The theory of value. The theory of value by Max Ferdinand Schiller. Of course, according to him, there are four levels in the there are four levels in his own theory. Now we call that level one. Level 1, then level 2, level 3, and level 4. Of course, level 4 is the highest, no? So the highest level of values. Here, when we talk of, according to Schiller or Max Ferdinand Schiller, level 1 will pertain to what we call the emotional value. When we talk of the emotional value, we are talking about what? Well, the decision on, when we talk about emotions, we are talking about the pleasure and displeasure of something. So, masyado siyang mababaw pa, no? When we talk of this emotional value, we are talking about deciding which is pleasurable and displeasurable. Diba? Emotional value. Whereas, level 2 now would pertain to what we call the sense of life value. Sense of life value. So you are talking about the essence of life or the sense of life, correct? What is important to you in life? Of course, if what is important is for you to serve, then that is the second value that you will have. Now, the third, according to Schiller, the third level three in the hierarchy of values is what we call the mental value. Now, when we talk of the mental value, we are talking about, because mental, it's more of the cognitive domain, no? Cognitive. Mental value, example of this is, of course, our perception, no? Perception, how you see things, no? Perception, beauty, what is beauty to you, beautiful to you? What is your concept of justice? So, remember that these are mental states or referring to the cognitive domain, mental, no? And then the fourth, of course, is what we call the highest would be the spiritual value. Meaning, we are not contented with what we have in this world, so we go beyond, no? We go beyond the material world. We think about the spiritual value. And this one, if you want to take a look at his work, the work of Max Ferdinand Schiller, you just find this, you Google this, and you will find the theory of value by Schiller, no? Or Max Ferdinand Schiller. I want you to read something about this so that you know what we are talking about. Okay, clear? So these are just my brief discussion of the theory of value by Schiller. So we proceed now with the third characteristic. No, the third characteristic of value is what we have as the third characteristic of value
is they are normative in character, no? So of course, you don't know if you understand the word normative, no? So they are normative in character. Normative values are normative in character. What do you understand by the word normative, no? When we talk of normative, we are talking about, these are evaluative standards, no? Evaluative standards, no? There is a point of evaluating, no? Something, no? You evaluate something because they are evaluative standards. What is good and what is bad? What is desirable? What is worthwhile or what is not desirable? There is always that you take the value or values as a form of evaluating something. No, evaluate, that is normative. Evaluating something. And that something, of course, is has something to do with if it is good or bad, desirable or not desirable, no, desirable or not desirable, permissible or impermissible, something that is worthwhile or not worthwhile, no? So you evaluate always the action or the behavior. That is what we call normative in character. Of course, the fourth general characteristic of values would be what? Any suggestion? What other characteristics of values that you know? Of course, next characteristic is what we call, they are abstract, no? Values are abstract. What do you mean by this word, abstract, no? When we talk of something abstract, we are talking something about, well, they have and have cognitive elements. Cognitive referring to the mind, no? Cognitive elements. They have cognitive elements. So when we talk of abstract, something that you could not physically see, something that you could not physically touch because it remains in the mind, no? Cognitive will refer to the mind only, no? So you cannot see values, no? You cannot see honesty because they remain in the mind or minds of people. You cannot see courage. You cannot see loyalty because these are abstract nouns. So when we talk of something that is abstract, it is not susceptible of being seen or being touched, no? Because they remain to be, they have this cognitive or mental elements, right? Values you could not see or you could not touch. They remain inside your minds. Clear so far? And the fifth characteristic of values would be what we call values are a matter of faith and belief, no? So here are this one, these two terms, if we define them, what is faith? No, this is reposing or residing your trust and confidence to something, no? Giving your trust and confidence to something because you believe that if you put your trust and confidence to that something, it will lead to something good. It trust and confidence that leads to goodness, no? That leads to goodness. Say for instance, of course, when you believe or when you have faith in honesty as a value, of course, will this lead to something good? The answer is yes. If you believe in the value of, say for instance, loyalty, will this lead to something good? Of course, the answer is yes. Now, what is faith? Belief rather. No, what is belief? You accept something as true, no? Even without proof. Even without proof, no? So these are two different terms. When we talk of faith, you give your trust and confidence to something because that you think that that will lead to something good. Whereas belief, you accept something as true, even there is not belief nga eh. So, that is already by belief. So, you cannot change that already. So, if you ask faith and belief, these are also cognitive elements. There are what we call cognitive elements. When we talk of cognitive, we are talking about the mind. No? I think I have to stop here because it might be too long for you to digest all the things that I have said. So we will continue on Wednesday morning. So that will be enough for now. I will not be giving you your first assignment yet because you are just starting it out. Perhaps by next week. No?
We continue. Now, if you want to have, actually this is the textbook that I am requiring you to have. No, this one is available in the LRI or Learning Resources Institute. That is all for now. Good morning, everyone.